Good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Yaroslav. I represent the Credits Project. And a big thanks to the previous two speakers of popularizing blockchain, the smart contracts platform, and raising the problem of scalability in blockchain. Seems like I've been born under a lucky star because this project solves these issues. So, to start about credits, what are the main problems in blockchain at the current stage? So it's low network capacity. Bitcoin is able to process 3 to 7 transactions per second, while Ethereum is around 200 to 500. The time of payments and the smart contract execution is really slow due to mining process and other processes, which were initially raised in blockchain version 1 to bring more end users, attract investments in form of mining pools. So the high cost is another issue, because due to cryptocurrency growth in USD equivalent, the cost of transactions grows proportionally, as it is usually a percentage of the transaction. So there are, the volume of the safe data is another issue, because blockchain is growing at a rate of approximately 10 gigabytes per second. So in order to have a full node for Bitcoin, you will need around 250 gigabytes on your computer. Currently, the end user has approximately 1 terabyte, so and it keeps on growing with a pace when all your storage on the computer will be filled just by your wallet, blockchain wallet. When you have several wallets, say Ethereum and Bitcoin, almost half of your storage will be filled by just 2 programs, 2 wallets. So smart contract restrictions is another issue which isn't solved yet, due to the fact that blockchain as a whole has only one working smart contract platform, which is Ethereum, the second largest cryptocurrency, maybe the third currently, because Ripple had a wonderful leap lately. This is a market of expectations. So we have 2018 now, and we are waiting releases from most projects like EOS, like Neo, and others, which have a market cap of $15 to $20 billion without even having a working project. So the main issue here, that this is a market of expectations, and people are overestimating the product while they haven't seen it. So, due to this factor, what is credits? Credits is a smart contract platform, a DLT, not a blockchain. So DLT is the more common area, while blockchain is just one example. Volume is up to 1 million transactions per second. So we are releasing our alpha version this month. At this stage, it is currently able to process 200 to 500,000 transactions per second, compared to Ethereum, which is only 200 to 500. So it's a multiple of 1,000 times higher. The speed of up to 3 seconds for an operation. The current price at the current cap is decimals of a cent. So we have a more advanced version of smart contracts due to scheduling and cycles. Just in comparison, so you can see the numbers on this slide. So while credits is scalable up to 10 million in a perspective of 2 years, with 200 to 500,000 in this month, 1 million in April, so beta is scheduled for April, and the final release will be in June with over 1 million transactions per second. So we are a DLT, as I said, decentralized ledger technology, while Ethereum and Bitcoin are classic blockchains. So that is why we don't have mining. All our tokens are pre-mined. Credits is much more faster, it's more stable than others and more secure due to a number of technical advantages which we have compared to standard blockchains. So it's a known blockchain, it's not Ethereum based or any other. We use a synchronous system, which means while one block is being formed, the next blocks are getting ready to be approved. So we don't have mining, we use a new consensus, which is a delegated proof of stake plus PFT, which is Byzantine fault tolerance. We use homomorphic encryptions and use archiving, meaning data compression, which solves the issue of growing data needed to store. So we don't need that much memory on your PC to be stored, so a laptop could be easily used as a node. So compared to Ethereum, which is our main working peer and only working peer, we use fully autonomous smart contracts. We have a friendly external API. We use cycles and schedules, so credits is not only faster, cheaper, and capable of processing more transactions, but it is also a more friendly, user-friendly, autonomous smart contract platform. So, where we can implement the technology? There's up to 30 sectors where smart contracts are used, so mainly in the financial industry, but we don't possess ourselves as a fintech and only financial industry based token. So the transition of value is interesting to banks, maybe other financial institutions due to the speed and ability to process more transactions than anything can process currently. Internet of Things is another way of application, so apart from finance and payments, gaming, gambling, trading operations, you can use it in medicine, education, logistics, and almost anywhere. So this is our roadmap. Our MVP, so minimum viable product, was released in August. You can take a look at it and test it on our website. So we held a pre-ICO in December and raised 4,000 Ethereum, which is equivalent to $5 million currently. We'll release our alpha version in January. We're holding our ICO in February. So currently we are processing our whitelist. We're already oversubscribed by 12 times. So we plan to raise 20 million and we have demand from the market for over 240 million currently. So we're not looking for investments, rather than we are looking for partners interested in implementing the technology. So in April, beta will be released, which will be capable of processing 1 million transactions, and the final release will be in June. A desktop application will be available in our alpha version, so also a web wallet and a block explorer. So it will be already a working product with no peers at the moment. So why credits is interesting? Because it would be the first cryptocurrency to solve the main issue of blockchain. So the results of our pre-ICO, so we collected $3 million, was our hard cap was fixed in dollars, so at the moment it was $3 million, now it's already up to $5 million. So we will have escrow, for the token, for the funds raised in ICO with a soft cap of 15 million, a hard cap of 20 million, scheduled for February 1st. So we have already over 9,000 people in Telegram, WeChat and Kakao. It's an old number. We have representatives in different countries, and we're opening a credits lab to assist businesses in developing something based on our platform in different countries, based on the demand and from companies. So this is our team, partly. Our CEO, Igor Chikunov, our CTO, Yevgeny Putaev. So our team, our legal entity is based in Singapore, while our team is based in Russia. So thank you for taking a look at our project, our presentation. Maybe some of you would be interested in partnerships with our projects. So maybe you would be interested in participating in ICO. We'll leave a part of our tokens for strategic partners interested, perhaps. So thank you.